So children, today we will study about germination of pollen grain on stigma or double fertilization in plants. Very important topic from board point of view. Now, for understanding this, see this diagram. All of you know pollen grain is the male germ cell and the female germ cells are present in the ovary of the plant. And in that flower, in ovary, there are ovules, which are the female germ cells. So when, due to the pollination, due to use of any pollinating agents, pollen grain gets stick on the stigma. That also we know that stigma produces sticky substance such that pollen grain gets stick over it. Thus, due to this sticky substance, it gets nourishment and gets germinated such that it develops a pollen tube, and this pollen tube, which I have shown with the red color, travels to the ovary and enters inside the ovary where are the ovules. First pollen grain, as you can see here, the first pollen grain enters through this pollen tube and enters and gets fertilized with these secondary nuclei. There are two types of the nuclei. These are the cornermore are the secondary nuclei and the inner ones are known as polar nuclei. As it is not labeled in NCERT, so I have not labeled, but you should know this. These are the secondary nuclei and these are the polar nuclei. So first fertilization of one germ cell, that is ovule or the female germ cells, take place with the male germ cell, that is pollen grain. And it forms diploid zygote. Why diploid zygote? Because male and female both are got fertilized and two cells have fertilized. That's why diploid. Now this diploid zygote is also known as syngamy, or this leads to the generative fertilization. Why generative fertilization? Because this will develop into the embryo. Zygote divides on and keeps on dividing itself and then ultimately develops into the embryo. This embryo is stored in the seed in the plants. The other male gamete also develops. Here, the other male gamete also develops this type of the pollen tube and enters in the ovary and gets fertilized with these polar nuclei. So with these polar nuclei, when these male gametes get fertilized with two polar nuclei, as you can see, how many are there? Three nucleus are there. Two of the polar nuclei and one of the male gamete, right? So three of these nuclei, when they fertilize, this fertilization is known as triploid. But this triploid do not form zygote, but it forms endosperm nuclei. This endosperm nuclei gives nourishment to the zygote, growing zygote into the embryo. Because you know, ovule and germ cell, male germ cell and female germ cell in the plants are very small. From growing into the embryo, they need nourishment, and this nourishment is given by this triploid, that is two polar nuclei and one male gamete. When they fertilize, they give nourishment to this growing zygote into the embryo. This endosperm nuclei is called triple fusion, and or this is also known as vegetative fertilization. Now there is one more important question in your NCERT, that what happens after fertilization in the plants. So ovary develops into the fruit after fertilization because it develops seed-like structure or cotyledon in the seed-like pulses, and it develops into the fruit in the fruit-giving plants, which is having some nourishment, some juices, and many more things, many more nutrients as well. And ovule develops into the seed and seed stores the seed stores the future plantlet that is called embryo, right? Which is stored in the seed. As I told you here, that after fertilization, this zygote or syngamy is developed into the embryo, and embryo is stored in the seed. So I hope it is clear to you.